So here we have a real life example of somebody earning a salary who actually manages to build up enough money to be able to be financially independent within a few years. The person, let's call him Skulk, is taking home 15,000 rand a month, and of that he manages to save 5,000 rand a month. In the beginning, what he will do is use that money to build up a cash safety net in something simple like a money market account. So it'll take him about a year to build up that safety net, because we tell him to keep about 60,000 rand in cash, and that's really just to help him in case he's got an emergency and he can use that money to fund any kind of an emergency that he has. Once he's done that, he then needs to start saving his 5,000 rand a month into a long-term investment. I like to recommend something simple and low cost, like an exchange traded fund, and if you go into something that's purely invested in shares, over a very long period of time, you would expect those shares to give you about 15% growth per annum if interest rates stay the way they are now. And so what will happen is Skulk will start saving that 5,000 rand a month, and within a period of, let's say, nearly 4 years, he'll build up about 300,000 rand of savings. So that's quite a nice amount of money, but it's certainly not going to be enough for him to retire on. What he needs to do now is take the big risk, and that's to actually go to a bank and borrow some money against that 300,000. In most banks, if you're a reasonable risk, they'll actually lend you about half the money that you've got saved already. They'll lend you as collateral against debt. So in other words, he's got 300,000 in savings. He now borrows 150,000 rand and will now need to pay the bank that money back. We did some personal finance or personal loans calculators, and it'll cost him about 3,900 rand a month to pay off that debt over a period of 5 years. So what it means now is Skulk can take that 150,000 rand and add it to that, the 300,000 rand that he's already got invested. So he'll now have 450,000 rand that will be now growing at about 15% a year. What it means is that in another sort of 5 years' time, approximately, he'll have a total of nearly 900,000 rand saved and invested, and he'll now be debt-free. So he's very close to having the million rand that everyone always aims for when they start investing, and that million rand he can now let it continue to grow, and while he's still saving his 5,000 rand a month. What it means is roughly within about 4 years from then, he'll have about nearly another 2 million rand or 2 million rand total saved. And that's really where the fun starts, because now the power of compounding works in his favor. It means he can roughly add about another million rand a year every 3 years. So it won't take him long by the time he's 38, 39 years old, where he'll have about 3 million rands worth of investments. He'll be completely debt free. He'll have a nice cash safety net and is on his way to financial freedom.